What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content, right here on YouTube. Today, I've got a really awesome tutorial for you guys to follow along with and recreate yourself in Adobe Illustrator. I'm going to show you some lighting techniques, as well as use of gradients and also brushes to recreate the Adobe logo in this cool manner that you're seeing on screen now. There's actually going to be two different variations on today's logo design. So follow along and recreate the Adobe logo in my style today with Satori Graphics. So today we're going to tweak the Adobe logo, and I'm going to show you two different variations of the logo using my lighting techniques in Adobe Illustrator. You can find the Adobe logo on Google and then open up an Illustrator so we can actually draw around the basic shape of the symbol itself. Press P for the pen tool and then use a stroke without a fill and carefully draw around the Adobe icon. My version of the Adobe logo is going to be made up of three shapes essentially, so follow how I draw around the logo and recreate it for yourself. So as you can see, there are three shapes that make up the Adobe logo. We need to make a new document, and then for the lighting effects, we're going to set the color mode to RGB, which is something I very rarely ever do in Adobe Illustrator. However, the lighting effects and the blends will look a lot better if this document is set to RGB. Drag your design over to a new document and then place it on the canvas. We can increase the stroke weight, and the color of the lines don't matter at this stage. If you have anomalies like I do here at the top of the A, open up the stroke window and use the same settings I'm using here. This should remove your anomalies. Now I'm going to add more lines within the Adobe logo to give it more detail and make it more interesting. We will add the lighting effects later in the tutorial. I'm going to speed up this section of the video because all you need to do is simply draw new lines in the same way that I'm doing, or you can get creative and go off on your own tangent on this part of the design. It's just a matter of building up your logo with a greater sense of detail so you can overlay lighting effects later. You can also take the direct selection tool by pressing A on your keyboard and move the anchor points to adjust your logo. So the logo is nearly ready to have the gradient and the lighting effects added. Remember, I'm showing you two different styles with today's Adobe logo design. Select everything and then go up to Object and Outline Stroke. This will turn all of your vector paths into vector shapes. To make sure the lighting effects that we add later really pop and are visible, we should add a dark background. So choose a dark color in the color palette and then press M for the rectangle tool. Draw a rectangle around your canvas and then send it to the very back and then lock it down in place so it doesn't move around. I also like to make a sample of the same color off to the side in case I need to use the same color of the background later, as the background's going to be locked. Now select your Adobe logo and go ahead and unite it together in the Pathfinder window, so it's now one vector shape. For the first style of the logo variation, we're going to add a gradient overlay here. For my design, I'm going to use a vibrant color from dark purple to bright pink. you can of course use whatever you feel works best for your logo design. We're now going to make a vital part of this tutorial, and that's a lighting effect brush. So grab the pen tool and draw a perfectly straight line by holding down shift on your keyboard. Apply the stroke style here and increase the stroke weight a little bit. So once you've done that, apply the outer glow. You can experiment with different colours, so maybe a bright pink glow or a white glow, it's entirely up to you. So as you can see here, my line has a nice outer glow to it. This would look terrible if the document was set to CMYK. Now open up the brushes window from the top drop down menu, or you can press F5 on your keyboard. With the line still selected, create a new brush in the top right corner of the window, and then choose Art Brush. As you can see, the auto glow line is now a brush, which is pretty awesome. You can delete the line and then use the Alt Option key to duplicate the Adobe logo. Flick the fill over to a stroke, then simply apply the auto glow brush in the brush window like so. And there is the first variation of the Adobe logo, and this does look pretty neat. For the second variation, we can take the pen tool and draw lines across the Adobe logo, and then apply the brush that we just made. Now, I didn't have much time today to finish this up myself, but I want to show you all this technique so you can do it for yourself and go ahead and make some cool designs. If you do make a cool design, go ahead and upload it on Twitter and tag me in your post, because I'd love to check it out. Remember, the direct selection tool is there if you want to go ahead and manipulate and move the anchor points around, which will reposition the areas of the lighting effect. So here are the two designs that I ended up with in today's video, brought to you by Satori Graphics. So there is today's graphic design tutorial in Adobe Illustrator, brought to you by Satori Graphics. Let me know what you guys thought of today's video down in the comment section below. And of course, if you do find my content useful and enjoyable, drop a like and also subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content. Which of the two styles that I showed you in today's video of the Adobe logo did you prefer? The idea in these kind of tutorials is that you take the technique shown in the video to go back into your own work and make your own cool designs. So if you're not totally clear on the technique shown today, go back and watch the video again, just to make sure that you're crystal clear on all the techniques I showed you in today's logo design tutorial. So, until next time, design your future today. Peace.